I believe communication is one of the critical features for this country and other countries to develop. One of the things that the World Bank says is for every 10% increase in connectivity, we get a 1% increase in GDP. Now, that also goes for the next step, which is high-speed data access. Now, we're still working in Africa here at getting access. But the real question is, well, what happens after we get basic access, when we have reliable data services? I won't use names, but sitting here in this auditorium, one network is back on 2G, and another network is at, was 400, 500 kilobits. This is not exactly high-speed internet. But the question, of course, always is, gee, what can you do with this? For us and for the students here, it's allowing education to come. We have a little bit of extra coming in. This education isn't only in a formal sense, but it's also in understanding AI. For those of you that were here in the morning, generative AI is something that is, it is genuinely a wow thing. It's something that's going to change the world.
Indeed.
So we're really looking forward to be part of that.
Indeed.
And to help Ghana and our employees to infuse AI through our educational system, through our company, through our government, and see how that can benefit the population.
Indeed. Leo, I must admit, it's such a thought. I see you speaking with passion, and I can see the sense of duty in you. How has it been for you in brief at 80?
It's not easy. The situation occasionally has caused great difficulties for it, but the employees and the enthusiasm of the employees and the gut and determination to continue going even when we're knocked down is what keeps me going, and we have this bright light in the future, not the one up there, but a different one, really bringing high-speed internet, a world-class network, and then the platform, the content, the education, the AI, the for us internally, it's also infusing project management throughout the company. These are the things that excite me, but also that keep me going. And it's the pride that I see in the employees when adversity hits. And adversity may be, I'll give you an example. 2 years ago, one of our major systems went down. And our computer hardware was out of service, out of manufacturing, out of support. So IBM told us, I can't help you. What happened? Our guys got down together at 3 o'clock in the morning. I went there. I saw in our data center they had taken pieces from here, pieces from here, cobbled together something and made it work. We got knocked down. We got back up. This type of attitude, I call it MacGyver. I don't know if any of you see it's a stupid American spy show. The important thing is the guy can make an atomic weapon with duct tape and a paperclip. That ability is something that if you guys can keep at this from university, you've suffered through school, you've suffered through university, bring that to a company. And I assure you, you will rise up as fast as possible. But this is also what keeps us going, because that attitude, that forge that has made us, will allow us with our new investment that's coming to really be able to hit the market, bring the Ghanaian people what they've been waiting for so long.
All right. I'll take my last questions about this. Discussion will be very much interactive. We'll still be engaging with the CEO after this event. We're going to do more of that. My last question I'm going to ask is about from Tigo and Airtel joining together, which is not a heavily marriage. Now we have it here as AT. It was during one time all the internet service in Ghana went down because the water indices gaps. The cable. It was only AT which was working as an internet service provider in the country. I guess nobody noticed that.
again, we've got people that the staff of the company, and I got to tell you, it's a Ghanaian company, and I'm really proud that it's a Ghanaian company. Forgive me, I know I'm a funny color, but we only have one expat in the whole company, and it's not me. Okay, so what we had was, because we're constantly searching for the best connection that we have, we ended up a couple of months before that, it was a landslide off the coast of Abidjan. We ended up taking a fiber cable that actually went back to Nigeria and then up to Europe. And that cable happened to be about 450 kilometers offshore. So the first three cables, which started at 100 kilometers offshore and then kept going, the first three cables were wiped out. That cable, I honestly, I'd like to say it was great skill and planning on our part. But it was that we had several cables in there. And that one cable, 3 months before, we had actually shifted over because we decreed that was actually the best cable around. So we were still up. It did show, there's something very important. It did show that we as a nation are weak in what I guess I would call a national cloud. Because you all remember what happened. You went to a bank machine and you couldn't get money out. We wanted to register, you know, everybody wanted an Airtel SIM, but we couldn't register it because the fingerprint readers go outside the country for reading, and that fingerprint machine was actually using a different cable. So the money machines, the Visa cards, so many of our, they're called processing centers, we're actually offshore, so it might be in Dubai, it might be in Europe. Okay, well, we actually now have a processing center here in Ghana. ECG sends something, I don't remember what it is, but they send something outside of the country. So I'm the biggest nationalist there is.
Lior, thank you, but I just wanted to use one word to describe the technology at AT now.
The best technology we have is the people. So I'm going to say is people. You got to have the right people behind the technology. And we've got the right staff.